morning, learning English is more fun. For today's lesson, we will learn about examining bias. This lesson is based on the most essential learning competency presented in the English 8 curriculum guide for the third quarter. The MELC covered in this lesson is to examine biases for or against made by the author. Before we start, read and study the following sentences. Place a happy face if the sentence connotes a positive message, and sad face if it is negative. Number 1. Wearing a face mask is not necessary. 2. Following the IATF protocols is a must. 3. Observing social distancing is optional. 4. Using rubbing alcohol is important. 5. People should not stay at home during pandemic. If you are going to analyze, these sentences conveyed positive or negative opinions about a certain issue. Opinions for or against are based from personal views that may be biased. Hence, it is important to examine biases that could influence one's judgment on a particular issue. Now, let's learn the concept of bias and ways to determine the author's biases. But first, let me ask you, what comes first to your mind when you hear the word bias? May pagkiling, may pagkampi, favoritism, prejudice, unfair, partial, subjective, one-sided. Yes, you are correct. Bias favors one side over another. It is a prejudice against something an author is writing about. Favoritism for something an author is writing about. Or in other words, bias refers to an author's expression of his or her own opinion on a particular issue without examining and presenting enough evidences. You're actually making a judgment without enough evidences, and that is being judgmental. This arises from the author's thinking, which may be influenced by personal beliefs, culture, attitudes, preferences, and past experiences. To further understand bias in writing, let's differentiate bias writing from unbiased writing. Bias writing is subjective, based on feelings or opinions rather than facts. It is personal. Unfair presentation of the issue focuses on one side. On the other hand, bias writing is objective, based on facts rather than feelings or opinions. It is empirical. Fair presentation of the issue focuses on both sides. To recognize bias, one must consider the following. Look for loaded words. These are words that are filled with emotions. Might be positive or negative, can reveal an author's opinion about his or her topic. B. Watch out for stereotypes. This happens when the author labels an entire group. C. Notice vague language or generalizations. It is when the author isn't using a specific language or words. D. Look for one-sided arguments. This is when the author presents only one side of an argument. Now let's have this question. When does an author become biased? An author becomes biased when he or she persuades the reader to believe on his or her stand of the issue by giving inaccurate information or false impression, even with or without the intention of misleading the readers. How do you determine the author's biases? To determine the author's biases and to understand his or her underlying purpose, you must look at the use of evidence and diction. Evidences can be in a form of facts and information, testimonies and direct observations, scientific and legal findings, and anecdotes and philosophical evidences. Diction refers to the words or expressions that help convey the stand of the author towards an issue. The words and expressions may indicate a positive or negative connotation or meaning. Like for example, positive connotation. My neighbor is a mature woman. The word mature means that the woman is well matured, mannered. This implies the author's positive view towards the woman. Negative connotation, my new neighbor looks too mature in that dress. The word mature means that the woman looks old in her dress. This implies the author's negative view towards the woman. There are some guide questions to check the author's use of evidence. First, does the author present more positive evidences to support one side of an issue? Or does the author present more negative evidences to disprove one side of the issue? And there are also some guide questions to check the author's diction. First, does the author use more positive words and expressions to present one side of an issue? Or the second, does the author use more negative words and expressions to present one side of an issue? Here are some possible sources of bias. Number one, the speaker or writer is relying on incomplete information. Two, the speaker or writing is trying to deceive the listener or reader. Three, the speaker or writer wants to believe what he or she is saying. Four, the speaker's or writer's past experience is influencing his or her thinking. And number five, the speaker or writer is trying to persuade the listener or reader.